And this is the difference between, you know, more experienced developers and beginners, is that beginners, they do write a lot of code for something very simple. And, you know, that's why I'm making these videos.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
In this video, I want to go through with you 10 top mistakes that I see Java developers make. So in here, I've got this main class with some examples, and I've got a bonus for you. So stay till the end because it's quite important. So here, let's go through the very first one, and that is the concurrent modification exception. So if you look into this piece of code in here, have a look, quite simple, where we've got an array with letters, and here we are looping through these letters. If word equals to A, then we remove the word altogether. Now, it turns out that if I run this code in here, this will fail. And that's because you are not allowed to delete while looping within a list. So what is the solution? The solution is to use an iterator. Let me show you the documentations. So with iterators, it allows the caller to remove elements from the underlying collection during the iteration with the well-defined semantics. So this is exactly what we need. So to change this from this to an iterator, what we do is we say basically words dot and then iterator. So we need to grab the iterator. And now here we say while. So instead of a for loop, we have the while loop. Well, iterator dot has next. So if this is the case, we can basically take this right here and paste that here, and the word comes from iterator dot and then next, right? So we grab the next element and we can name this as word. And to remove, we just invoke iterator dot and then remove. So this is basically the solution. And this is something that I've seen people do quite a lot, to be honest, and you're not allowed to delete while looping, right? So let's just run this, and you can see that the error goes away and we're finally able to remove. Now, before I continue, let me show you something really nice, which I've seen people asking me quite a lot. And that is the new UI for IntelliJ. So here, if I go to settings, in here settings, and I can enable the new UI. So under appearance, enable new UI, and feel free to check the compact mode. So takes less screen space. I don't know what this is, by the way. And then apply. And restart. There we go. And you can see that it's already looking much, much better, right? Assalamu alaikum. If you are enjoying this video, literally just take 1 second and smash that like button so I can keep on bringing you content like this. Also, IntelliJ is telling me that I can replace this while loop with collection.removeif. And you can see that this is a much better approach. Next, let's move on to generics in here. So this is quite important. Now here we have an array list, and here we're adding numbers, strings, and whatnot. So what is the issue here? Well, the issue is that you are mixing data types together, and you know that you cannot add basically a string with a number, right? It just doesn't work. So what you do is you basically use generics. So here you basically say, right, so here I'm only allowing integers like that, and I need to have the diamonds in here. And you can see that this will not even compile, which means that it avoids common errors like this. So let's just get rid of it. And our code now works, and we don't need even to cast anymore. So this is the beauty, okay? So this is the second thing that I see people do a lot. And also, just a bonus tip for you, never do this. Array list equals to new array list. What you should do is say list in here. And the benefit for this is that if you want to change implementations, so within list, so list, you can see that there's a bunch of implementations. So here, look, all of these implementations, including linked and then list in here. And I think also a stack as well, right? So if you want to then change implementation, all you do is you just say, right, so I want to go from an array list to a linked list, like so, and you can see that the code works beautifully, right? And if I run this, this works the same as having a list, but the underlying implementation is quite different. Awesome. So also, in here. So list, right? So just like that. And this is what you should always do. Awesome. Let's move on to the third thing, which is equals in here. And this one is quite interesting. And if you've taken my masterclass course, I cover this in detail on how strings are stored in memory. But never, never, never compare strings using double equals, because double equals compares the memory location, right? So basically, obviously here they are going to be the same because strings are stored within the string pool. But as soon as I do this, so new and then string, just like that. Now it's a completely different story. So this is pointing to one memory location and this is pointing to a different memory location, right? So this is why you never compare strings like that. And instead, even IntelliJ is telling you that you should replace with dot equals and job done. And then you can also go back and replace this with like the short version of creating strings instead of creating a brand new object, because really what we aim is for performance, okay? And we should use what the language gives us instead of writing bad code, okay? Perfect. The next thing is, so this should actually be just ifs in here. So the next thing is, if I collapse this, let's look into this ifs method in here. So we have a boolean in here, a equals to a, and then I've seen people do this. Bool equals to true, return true. Bool equals equals to false, return false, and then all, and then at the end return false. Now don't do this. This is bad. Why? Because the result of this is either going to be true or false, right? Therefore, in here you could just say bool. You could just say literally bool. That's it. So this will be either true or false. If it's true, it will execute this. If it's false, so in here, so if it's false, what you do is you just basically flip the value, right? So if it's false, then return false, okay? And then this is actually pointless. So what we can do is we can get rid of all of that. And to even simplify the whole thing, we can get rid of all of that and just return. So this is, I've been teaching at boot camps and I've seen people do this quite a lot. So there we go. And this is much better. Cool, moving on to the ternary operator. So here, when you have an if statement, which is dead easy and simple, where basically you're checking whether the age is greater or equal to 18, return adult, otherwise return something else. You can do this in one line, okay? So also actually, if you want, you could just do this, right? Like that, it's the same thing. But the preferred option is to replace the entire thing with return, and then this is your condition in here, and then have a question mark. So you just ask a question: is this true? Well, if it's true, then return the first option, otherwise return the else, right? So here I'm gonna say child. So this is much better, okay? There we go. And this is the difference between, you know, more experienced developers and beginners, is that beginners, they do write a lot of code for something very simple. And, you know, that's why I'm making these videos. Cool. The next issue that I see is statics. Well, if you want to invoke this method in here, so statics from within this main method. So here, if I want to say statics, I'm not allowed. Why? Because I'm within the static method, right? So the main method is static. Now here you have two options. What you can do is you can create a new instance of this class, which is called mistakes dot and then statics. Okay. Or if you don't need a new instance of it, you could just make this static, right? So this is how I've been doing the other ones. So you make it static, and therefore you don't need a new instance, and you could just call it directly. And if you are outside of this class, you just invoke it by the name of the class dot and then statics. Okay, cool. Let's move on to, so statics out of the way, and this one also. Let's move on to switch statements. So this one is very important. Have a look at this piece of code and see whether you know what the issue is. Literally 2 seconds. One, two, Cool. So here, the issue is that we are missing the break statement. Where? Well, in here, right? So if I run this code, so if I say switch in here, so instead of statics, so switch, if I run this, this gives me 0 and 1, right? So we don't want this. So if I scroll down, have a look in here. So case, whether it's 0, is just going to print 0 in here, and it's going to find the next break, which is in here, right? It's going to find this one, and then just basically break out of it, because the condition wasn't met. Now, what we really want is to print just 0 and then break out of this. So break, just like that. Now, if we run it, you should see that we have 0. Nice and easy. The next mistake is when dealing with files. So you forget to basically do something, which I'm about to tell you right now. So look at this code in here. What is the issue with this code? Have a look. So we open a file, we do some stuff, we read it, and then we just leave it hanging. We just leave it hanging, basically. That's the issue, right? So we just leave it open, right? We don't close, we don't free the resources. So usually what you need to do is say in here, input. So we didn't finally, usually dot and then close here, and job done. So this is the best thing to do, right? Within finally, basically. But you see that it's very easy for us to forget this. So what we do is we use try with resources. So what we do is we encapsulate this entire thing in here within try, like that. So try and then open parentheses, and on this side as well. So you close and then have curly brackets, and you put all of this inside, just like that. And this right here invokes the close method for us, try with resources, right? So this is the technique. Awesome. Let's move on to the next one. Oops. Let's move on to the next one, and that is excessive garbage collection. Now, I've done a video, I think was 3 weeks ago, about this. And here, basically, what we are doing is we are creating a million of these. And by the way, one trick is if you don't know how to read long numbers, which I think you do, then you could basically use underscores like that. And this is 1 million, okay? So here, never do this within a loop. So concatenate into a string within a loop, because what you're doing is you're just basically allocating a million new strings without reason, okay? So what you do is you basically use the string builder. Even IntelliJ is telling you don't do that. So here you create one instance instead of 1 million, and then you append to it. So this is a much better approach when looping. Cool. The other one is nulls and optionals. So I've seen that people usually work with nulls, and this is actually bad, right? So never return a null, because the caller of your API doesn't know whether this can be null, right? And you don't want to force them to say null for everything, right? So one time your API works, the other time it doesn't work, or you're not even telling it whether this returns null or not. So what you do instead is you use optionals. Optionals. So here, I've got a video on optionals as well, if you want to learn about optionals on YouTube. And here, instead of null, you say optional dot and then empty. And then here, you can say optional dot of and then the value. Okay? Now, within main, what we do is we could just invoke the method. So nulls, and I think I need to make this static. There we go, static. Go back to main. And in here, I can say nulls and optional dot, and then have a look. Or else, if it's null. Or else get, or throw, right? You can see that this is much better. I can say or, and then something else, right? A supplier, actually, right? So that's basically nulls. And I think this is pretty much it. Now, the last thing, which is the bonus, really, is libraries. So one thing that I want to say here quite quickly is, if you want to build something, never reinvent the wheel. So try and find a library which has been written by someone else. And I'm pretty sure that you will always find it. And the second thing is, don't just use a library just for the sake of using it. For example, Lombok. If you're using Lombok and you just need one annotation from it, what is the point? Okay? Because the language itself has been improving and you can take advantage of the core strengths that the language gives you instead of using external dependencies, because you never know that there might be a vulnerability. There might be a vulnerability and you are tight into it, right? And don't just use dependencies just for the sake of using them. Just make sure that you have a reason behind it. And this is pretty much it. If you enjoyed this video, thumbs up, like literally smash the like button, and let me know what you want to see next. This is pretty much it. I'll catch you in the next one. Assalamu alaikum.